I didn't see you there.
It's 11 o'clock in beautiful Kingston, New York, and time for brunch with the Broidos.
That's us.
That's us.
That's us.
Today, we'll be doing a name doodle, and we'll be making egg salad.
Egg salad. Okay, I like egg salad.
I know you do. So, why don't you explain what you're doing while I peel the eggs?
Okay.
Don't do that at the same
time. This is a more or less useless craft project for adults when you want to kill some time. And I'm going to write my name on a piece of folded paper. And then I'm going to cut it out. And then I'm going to open it up. And this is because I can't be the star of the show today and do cooking for you, so I'm just going to sit here and do this while Jeffrey is... What is Jeffrey doing?
Of course, egg salad, peeling eggs. Of course, egg salad is rocket science, I know. And everybody needs to watch us make egg salad because it's something that hasn't been done since 1926.
Then why is there a National Egg Salad Day that they celebrate?
I can't help that. Can't help it.
But there is. It goes on permanently.
It goes on permanently in Benville. Anyhow. Three eggs. Using my perfect egg peeling technique that I learned when peeling the eggs at Camp Devon Saranac in 19... Let's see, when was that? 64, maybe 63, something like that. I was the head waiter and I had to make the hard-boiled eggs that were required by the state of New York. We make about 100 or 150 of them, and I peel them all, and the kids wouldn't eat any of them. I would sit there the rest of the Sunday eating hard-boiled eggs in the walk-in cooler.
Didn't you also cook these in there?
Yeah, but Sunday I ate eggs because we had to get rid of all those eggs that the kids didn't eat that we had to serve because of the mandate.
The hard-boiled egg mandate.
The hard-boiled egg mandate. You had to have so many hard-boiled eggs a week.
Which president mandated the hard-boiled egg mandate?
Oh no, it was a governor. It was a governor. I don't know. It was the state health, whatever it was.
Who was governor then?
I don't know. We'll have to look that up, but I don't think it matters. Anyhow.
Oh, it's not.
I have six hard-boiled eggs here, and I'm going to put three in this one, and I'm going to put three in this one, and you'll find out why soon. Alrighty, so now I'm going to do some chopping. So Barbara's just cutting her name out there.
Yes. Cutting my name out.
Alrighty. Pre-washed celery. Do a little bit of this business, which actually does something. You'll notice that I'm only beveling one side. That's because this is a sushi knife, which, as anybody who's ever tried to make sushi knows, you're supposed to use to cut sushi, cut maki.
Is this a knife that has names on it?
Oh yeah, it's got all these notches on the handle. I'll show you the notches if you can see it. Maybe you can't.
I'm on there. I am on there.
Yeah, you're on there. I'm on there several times. This is the knife that practically killed many people at Unity Charter School. Know how sharp it was, including me. And let's see who's on there. Joy, Jeff, Jill, Jeff, Barb, Jeff.
You'll notice there's more Jeffs than anyone else.
This knife is so sharp, even though it's not serrated, I used to use it to slice the bread hot out of the oven. And sometimes I got a little carried away. Competing salad dressings. Actually, let me get a cutting sheet. We're really prepared here today, as you can see. I learned my fine cutting technique from Miss Cynthia Rachel Gold and Alton Brown.
I thought it was Ken Kenichi.
Well, no, that's the chopping. The cutting... Cindy told me how to hold my hands to keep from cutting my fingers off. You curl your fingers under so that the knife hits your... the side of the knife hits your knuckles when you get down to the end. And Walton Brown taught us how to cut an onion. It's extraordinary.
Yes.
I'm not going to do that, though, because I only need a little red onion, and I don't want to cut up the whole thing. But maybe someday we'll show you how Walton Brown showed us how to cut an onion. Or, if you like, you can look it up. How's it going over there? How far did you get?
You can see the bee already.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, look at that. All right. Remember, this is useless.
Totally.
Yep.
Now I will peel carrot.
It's like I ate yours.
Yeah. So, we still can't think of anything to talk about, except maybe the fact that...
Are you hiding that you're peeling that carrot backwards?
Why don't you forward according to me? Barbara likes to peel this way, and I like to go this way because I find it faster.
It's not faster if you want to race.
Someday.
Someday I'll have a carrot race.
Okay. I'm not going to cut this whole carrot up, maybe this much. Just read a poll this morning that the four leading GOP contenders for the 2012 presidential nomination are each and every one neck and neck with President Obama. This is very strange. How could it possibly be that anybody could want to elect, say, Rick Perry as President of the United States? Look where he comes from. He looks like George Bush Jr.
I think he has surgery to look more like him.
Yeah, looks like it.
Or maybe he's a marionette. Maybe they're churning them out.
Well, yeah. Look for Cheney at the controls, I guess.
You know, he was created by Karl Rove, and he's not stoppable now.
No. Both of them were created by Karl Rove, George W. Bush and Rick Perry, apparently. Did you know that Rick Perry has been governor of Texas for 10 years, I think, 11 years, and something like that. And of the 475 executions carried out in Texas since the early 1980s, 275 of them, oh, well over half, were during Rick Perry's term. And of course, some percentage of those people were found, some significant percentage of those people were found to be innocent later. And,
well, that's interesting.
Yeah. But it's okay with them. It's okay with them because they were taught in Sunday school that it doesn't matter if you die because there's eternal life, so it's okay.
I think there's an execution clause that you don't get to go.
Oh, yeah? Well, at least they go someplace.
Oh, they do. I didn't get into talking about executions.
It just impressed me when I read that yesterday. I mean, Texas is already known for its execution fever. And this just... I don't know, just horrifies me. I'm a compulsive putter away.
That's now.
Now, yes. Okay.
I'm so sorry I threw away all of the evidence of Jeffrey's hoarding ways so you can see how much he's improved. He's really quite a neat now.
Someday maybe we'll show you pictures of the house that I took, of the old house that I took before Barbara moved in. Quite amazing.
Yes, he went away one weekend and left the door open. And when he got back, he was rather startled to see that everything was still there.
It was more than I went away for the weekend. In fact, I went to visit you in Shokane. And I stayed, what, a week and a half that time? So the door was actually open a week and a half. Alrighty. Ah, one more thing. Let's see, where is it? Where is it?
What are you looking for?
I'm looking for the cider vinegar. I'm looking for a fork.
You know, if you don't want it to get all liquidy, I now have cider vinegar powder.
I only put in a drop. I know you don't want it anyhow, do you?
What, vinegar?
In yours?
I don't really need it.
Okay.
I mean, you put all this stuff in there. All simply
right.
Doesn't belong in egg salad.
I know. Okay, so first.
Who puts carrots in egg salad?
Barbara's is going to be this one because you'll see how much stuff she likes. And I'm just going to mash the eggs a little with the fork, leaving it more or less chunky. Mash these eggs. Now.
You can do a really nice job. Take a hard-boiled egg.
Yeah.
You put it in your hand and you just squeeze
it. I've done that
it,
too, but then you
but don't. But you don't let anybody see it.
Yeah, right,
let.
Right.
But Julia Child did say that you are alone in the kitchen where no one can see.
Okay, we have a, well, yes, but you can see and so can they. We have a new jar of Hellman's Best Food mayonnaise. Oh, it's got this thing on it. They never give you anything to grab. I guess I'll just stab it! Death.
Violence in the kitchen. You love it. All because of Tylenol. Hundreds of millions of dollars of secret flaps and...
Oh, it's terrible. Yeah, it is Tylenol, but maybe some of these people don't remember. How much mayonnaise do you want for 3 eggs? Is that good? A little more, a little less?
I think that's good.
That's what I thought. Now... The Whip de Miracle. A drop of vinegar, just. All right, now I will put stuff in mine. Onion.
What about pepper?
Oh yeah, good idea.
Not green pepper.
I know. What? Onion. Carrot. Oh,
yeah.
Celery.
This is egg salad.
More carrot.
Salad.
More carrot. Okay, now, how much of this stuff do you want in yours?
A little hint of onion.
Hint? A little more
two
hint?
2 hints of celery.
Hint? No carrot, huh?
Hints.
Is that a hint? Oh, that's 2 hints.
2 hints.
2 hints.
Yes.
Okay, and the rest of the hints will go in my... Mine will last a lot longer.
Not long.
And now we need...
It will last one sandwich plus finishing what's left over because there isn't enough to do anything with.
Sed? You want sed?
No.
Et poivre? Poivre? Poivre. Sort of say it right. Poivre?
Okay.
A little more?
No.
Oh! Please didn't go in my cellar.
Oh,
that was not planned, folks.
It's everywhere. It's everywhere.
You see, we don't have to plan these things because. Suffice it to say, when I was in college, they called me Spastic Man. Are you watching this, Jim Micah? It's all over the table. Oh, look at that. All of the Miracle Whip cap. la la la. Okay, now all I gotta do is mix it.
Would you like to set up the rolling pin, and then the rolling pin can slide downhill?
What, are we gonna make that a tradition that's always gotta happen?
No.
There it goes. There it goes. Whoa! Oh,
can I eat a carrot?
Huh?
I want the carrot.
Eat it.
No, it's not a peel. Where's the peeler?
Oh, that goes back. Oh, it's the tunnel.
Oh, there.
Hello.
Yeah.
It's Jane.
Why, Jane, you're on the air now.
Jane,
as we speak.
We're making a movie.
And you're in it.
Okie dokie.
Bye.
So that was Rock Light.
Did she call for no reason?
James the Beal. Okay, now.
I'm just peeling.
Why? What are you going to do with it?
Eat it.
Oh, okay. All right. So all I have to do now is mash it up, put the stuff away.
One of these days I will climb Temple Pagoda out of one of the giant Chinese carrots for y'all.
Oh, yeah. You should see these carrots. If you don't have, if you have an Oriental grocery near you, maybe they have them. They're what we call horse carrots. They are so fabulous. They're sweet. People would never stand for it in a modern supermarket because they look industrial almost.
Well, they look like they couldn't possibly be sweet, and they are the sweetest carrots you can
absolutely
find.
Except the closest grocery that has them to us is in Albany, which is quite a distance. So we used them up from our last Albany trip. All right, here is Barbara's egg salad, and here is my hefty egg salad.
Should I blow this off the table?
You're gonna eat it.
No, the.
Oh, that? Oh no, I'm gonna wipe it. I'm just gonna wipe it. I have to take my stabbing knife and my cutting knife and. Did you show that you didn't finish the main noodle? Did you show it?
No.
I didn't think so. You must.
No, I was laughing too hard.
We'll do it now.
Wait a minute. They're going to need something to see this. They saved this for me.
Oh, okay. I'll get something.
So, here you can see, here's my name.
Oh, how about a tray? Picasso tray. Oh, it's white on the back. I'll find something. We're so well prepared here.
Well, I'll just put it on the wood table. Kind of looks a bit like Crusader Rabbit. Do you remember Crusader Rabbit?
Here, put it on the clipboard.
On the clipboard. The tune in the clipboard. It is this. The reason they call these doodle bugs is that they almost always end up looking like bugs. So here's my name. You can see it here. It's reflected here. It's useless.
But attractive.
Yes, useless but attractive. And of course now you know how to make one.
And if I were still a hoarder, I would keep it forever.
No, you won't.
But I'm not.
No. Okay. Is it time to eat?
It's time to eat. Once again, we won't show you the eating because that's
you can put this
even more boring than the making.
You can put this on the side of
I'll
my
do that.
Wrap.
I'll do that. Excellent. Oh, you want to wrap? Okay.
You've already seen wraps.
Yeah, you've already seen wraps. You don't want it on a piece of toast?
Piece of toast.
Which would you rather, toast or wraps?
I'm kind of in an onion rye sort of. Do we have any?
Yes, we do. Okay. Okay, folks. We will, uh-oh. What happened to it? Did you use it up for the
left ends?
I put
them in the tomato surprise.
So this is what we got. Onion rye. That's it.
One piece?
Yeah.
You have olive bread.
All right. I'll do olive bread. Okay, folks.
Okay.
It's been lovely.
Lovely. See you next time.